Hello, friends. My name's Alissa, and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. And today, I'm going to show you how to make a simple toy that I call an anti-gravity cup. And it's something that you can use outside on a hot day. So I'm going to fill this little yogurt container up with water. And now I'm going to swing it around so it goes upside down. And if I do it right, the water won't spill out. That's why I call it an anti-gravity cup. Make a prediction. What do you think's going to happen? Am I going to stay dry or am I going to get wet? Here we go. 3, 2, 1. That's pretty good, huh? Here's the things you'll need to make your anti-gravity cup. First, you'll need a cup or a container of some kind. Doesn't really matter how big it is, but it should be something that you'll be able to poke a hole through. And you definitely don't want to use anything that's glass or ceramic or anything that breaks easily in case you drop it. You'll need some string, a pair of scissors, and some water. You'll need to poke holes into your cup near the top, but not right at the top. So a little below, and make two holes opposite each other. You'll need a grown-up to help you with this part, because depending on the kind of container that you have, you might need a special tool to get the holes in. Maybe a drill, or an awl, or a screwdriver, but whatever it is, get a grown-up to help you. And then once you've got the holes in, take some string and run it through and tie it off so that you have your handle. That's it. Now let me show you how it works. Okay, so this is how you use your anti-gravity cup. First, fill it with water. And then, it's all in the wrist. You don't want to whip your whole arm around too much, and you want to try and get it going as evenly as possible. It definitely takes some practice. And when you're ready to stop, you want to go slow enough so that you can stop it, but not so slow that all the water falls out. I lost some water that time, but who cares? I'm outside. All right, I'm going to try it again, but this time I'm going to go over my head. Sounds crazy. Ready? Whoa! Don't worry if you don't get it right the first time. Like most things, it takes practice. Now that you've gotten the hang of using your anti-gravity cup, it's time to play around with variables. Do you remember what variables are? It's when you change one thing about your experiment to see if it has an effect on the results of your experiment. So in this case, there's a few things you can play around with. You can change the length of the string. Maybe you make it really long or really short. Does that make it any easier? You can play around with the amount of water. Try experimenting with how fast you swing the cup. Swing it to your side or over your head. See if you can switch from one hand to the other. There's lots of ways you can play around with your anti-gravity cup. And the best thing is, if you mess up and drop it down, the worst that happens is you get a little wet. And on a hot day, that's not a bad thing. I hope you have lots of fun with your anti-gravity cups. If you decide to make one, send us a picture, or better yet, a video of yourself playing with it. Thanks for joining me today, and keep checking back here on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for more fun things you can do at home. See you next time.